Well, that's the nearly completed Cape Town Stadium, and I'm here with Colin and Andy, and we're just finishing off the programme. We've just got the last little bit of the show to record. We just thought it'd be fitting to finish the programme outside the stadium, which is a great idea in principle, apart from the fact it's locked down with some pretty major security.
This time for Africa. So let's get to the spirit of the
World Cup fever has hit South Africa, and it's great. Listen to your dad, this is
our mind. Your time to shine, don't wait in record. Line. Record. Andy's very excited. Are you excited, Andy? Do you love the World Cup, Andy? Go on and feed him, this is your moment, no
hesitation. But away from the shiny new football grounds, this place, Bridgetown, a neighbourhood that's home to gangs and drug dealing, and where we met this guy.
On and off, no, like selling and smoking, dance games, going in, no, all the types of stuff that happened in the underworld.
He told us about his own dealings with the gangs. But just up the road, a place where talking, sharing and technology have changed some for the better.
And Monique, tell us your story. How did you get involved with all this?
My story is basically that I was on substance abuse for 8 years, roughly. Then it was a Tuesday evening that I walked through the doors of the Impact Centre. I know deep down my desire was to be reunited with my family, because while I was in drugs, I had complete... I lost all contact with him. I also ended up staying with my boyfriend.
Monique's then-boyfriend is now her husband, and if she's addicted to anything now, it's Twitter. On Digital Planet this week, the guy next to her, Brent, tells his story too. It's powerful listening.
So, yes, Pastor Roger, they spoke to me.
And on the programme this week, we're also here in the Khayelitsha township. It's huge, home to 1.6 million people, one of whom is this fella.
We sell computers, brand new refurbished.
In a poor part of town that the big multinationals are reluctant to move into, not only does Livoyo sell computers, he sells training courses to people who've never even touched a PC before. It's kind of like an internet cafe, computer shop and training centre all rolled into one.
This is the Freedom Toaster. What's a Freedom Toaster? Well, it's something that gives you pretty much whatever you want, whether it's software, education, music, those kinds of things. For instance, software. I want some software so I could get the Ubuntu operating system. And then I might say, oh, I don't know, I fancy some music and I'm into rock. So I'm going to add that to my basket. And then finally, I want an ebook. I want to go away and do some reading. So hopefully do the Count of Monte Cristo. Yes, they do. I brought my USB memory stick, even though it's not actually a stick, but it's still USB. Oh, little blue light flashing. The blue light, not of cheapness, but of freeness. All this stuff, the book, the distro, and the music going for free. Onto this. Brilliant. What's not to love? The Freedom Toast, ladies and gentlemen.
My head.
That's brilliant.